Children of Standard 5, we have been discussing the test paper 2 that includes all the previous chapters that we have read in our previous classes. So children, in my previous video, I discussed about all the fill in the blanks that is given in test paper 2, and now for today, I'm going to discuss the short answer questions. Our first question is, what are floating ribs? Children, all of us know that the ribs are 24 in number. There are 12 pairs of ribs. And the last two pairs of the ribs that are not attached to the sternum are called floating ribs. So it means all the 10 pairs of ribs are attached to the sternum. So floating ribs are not attached to the sternum, and there are two pairs of floating ribs that are not at all attached to the sternum. So they are called floating ribs. Our second question is, explain ball and socket joints. We have studied a lot about ball and socket joints. And ball and socket joints are those joints that allow circular movement. These joints are found in shoulder and hip. All of us know that the at the place of ball and socket joint, that is first we discussed about the shoulder, that is where the ball and socket joint and humerus, the first part, the forelimb, the upper part of the forelimb that is the attached to the shoulder in the form of ball and socket joint. So humerus and shoulders are joined. And in the pelvic zone, children, the hip girdle is joined with the our femur. So that is also called ball and socket joints. And third question is, discuss ways to take care of your eyes. We also studied about how to take care of our eyes, because all of us know the light enable us to see the things, and there are the function of retina and the function of the formation, how the image is formed on retina, and how our you can say the optic nerve sends the messages to our brain to intercept the images, and how we understand. So the eyes, we can take care of our eyes by washing it with clean water every day and not sitting too close to the television. And we should always read while facing towards the source of light. And we should always, once a year, we should go to the doctor for the condition, to see the condition of our eyes. And we should not rub our eyes with the clothes that is used by others, because our eyes can get the infection. And all of us know this is a very delicate organ, and it should be protected, and it should be used with the eyes should be, we should take care of our eyes. Now, the discuss ways to take care of your tongue. We can take care of our tongue by cleaning it regularly and not eating too hot things and rinsing our mouth after every meal. Children, all of us know there are taste buds on the tongue, and if we take the very hot and very cold things, it really makes our taste buds numb, because all the taste buds are related with our nerves that really gives us the sense of taste. So our tongue should be taken care very carefully. And how does our nose function? Our nose, we breathe and smell through our nose, and special nerve cells in the nose send the smell message to the brain, and the hair in our nostrils filter the air entering our body. So children, the hair that is present inside our nostril are really filtering the microbes and the dust particles that are going to enter our nasal passages. So these hairs are really protective, and you can say that our special nerve cells in the nose that really sends a smell message to the brain are very important, and they are giving us the smell of the things that are around us. So children, our next question is, how does our tongue function? Our tongue helps us in speaking, eating and tasting, and our tongue is covered with 2000 to 8000 taste buds. And children, our tongue also gives us the taste of the things, and our tongue should be protected and should be taken care of very carefully, because tongue is the organ that mixes the food with the saliva and make it soft, softens the food so that it can easily go to our food pipe, that is esophagus. So this is all about for the short answer questions for today. We will discuss later on the rest of the short answers questions and long answers questions in my next video.